And so I think, you know, it's a fairly light clean, but I know she keeps things pretty dusted. You know what I mean?
Like, yeah.
Especially in these main.
You can go anywhere. Two years ago, I was contracted out to this historical museum to clean those rugs. There's 14 wool rugs, and we VLM cleaned those rugs. And they liked our work, so now we're back out giving them an estimate at this historical building. I believe this is one of the first buildings in town, and it's been transferred into a state office. This is one of the state offices right by the Capitol. So we have been contracted out to give them an estimate, and we're going to give them a proposal. I'm going to write it up, and then I'm going to send it to them tomorrow, and we'll see how it goes. But I've already done the carpets, and they remembered that we do all sorts of cleanings, so they called us to see if we would be willing to take on this office cleaning. Now, whenever I get these calls, I'm not just looking at, just how to clean the office and what I'm going to do and how I'm going to charge. I'm also paying attention. The rugs, I'm going to want to clean those again. Tile and grout, showers, I want to get those restored and cleaned really nice. That's an extra price to remove the soap scum and the calcium buildup and the scale and all that. Tile and grout, that's an extra charge. You know, that's what's going in my head. There's wood floor. I charge extra to bring out the buffer. Extra price there. All these things are going in my head. I'm making notes. I got this on video. So I'm looking at all the things that I could clean outside. Is the sidewalk dirty or not? The walkway, all that I am considering. So when the time comes, they're going to need those services as well. I hand them the flyer with all my paperwork, and the flyer has all my different services. They know that's what services I provide. So, and the estimate, I'll put that on the estimate as well, what we would charge for those services. So keep that in mind when you take these cleaning jobs. You're not just focusing on cleaning the bathroom and wiping the toilet and dusting the desk and blinds. You're taking into account that all the different things you can clean. You can clean windows, you clean big mirrors, you can clean the rugs, the wood floor, pressure wash something outside. All that sort of thing you can keep in mind, because why not, right? You got your foot in the door. They know about your other services. There you go. You got the job. And these things need to be done regardless. So rather than always advertising and marketing, which you want to do, but you know, at some point, you just don't want to think about always having new people, right? So my goal is to have this client, this estate office, and have them as regular clients and not having to look for clients. This one is a referral. I got the rug cleaning job from a person that I cleaned their carpets and did work for, and then they recommended me to do the rugs. So that's how I got this job, or how I got this estimate. And hopefully it works out well. We'll send in the proposal and see what happens. This is a beautiful building, by the way. It's like 18 something, I don't know, but the craftsmanship on these types of places, they're second to none. Just look at it. Just beautiful. But anyways, that's why I just wanted to share that, because retaining clients, referrals, that's the key to growing. That makes your life easier, and you don't always have to chase down people and work and all that, jobs just fall into your lap sometimes when you do good work.